Good morning, guys. It is, I guess, the first sort of proper day in Venice. It's about 10 o'clock. I've gone downstairs. Turns out that I've got breakfast included as part of the accommodation or whatever. So that was neat. I'm going to be able to save some money there with breakfast. So I literally just inhaled the food down. It'll keep me going for a while. And I've just noticed that this light right there is the only one that is there, but then they have like a mirror here, but you can't really use it because there's no light, so it's a bit like, what is the point of having it there? So yeah, it's about 10 o'clock. I'm just waiting for my nails to dry because I decided to paint them properly. They were looking a bit crooked. It is -4, hence I have got this fleece on. This fleece I bought for about £10. If that, from Trespass in Manchester, and it is the best thing ever. I'm gonna have to go back and buy like a second one or third one because I literally have been living in this since I got it for Iceland, and it is so warm and cozy. And because it's got like the neck warmer type thing here at the top, the collar, it's cozy. And since I forgot my scarf and my flipping gloves and my hat, this is gonna be perfect. And I think I'm gonna just have to layer up for the next few days. But it's -4 today. Let's have a look. It said -4 earlier on. One of my friends messaged me, Emma, who was on my Iceland vlogs. She was like, oh my God, it is -4 there. I hope you are wrapping up. It's warmed up a little bit. As you can see, it now says -3. It's looking like it's gonna be in the -1s most of the day, and sunset is around about 10 to 5 this evening, so that's plenty of time to get a lot of photos in. I think I'm going to try and head into an area called Rialto, if I'm pronouncing that right. It seems to be sort of like the central hotspot around here, which I like and which I don't like. Hopefully check out the square as well. I did pack my drone, so I want to take the drone out, so I'm thinking maybe tomorrow morning I'll get up super early. And hopefully if it's nice and bright like it has been today so far, then we can go and get some drone footage from maybe around the square there. You can't really see outside from my room, which I'm a bit gutted about. So I think next time we're in Venice, we're going to have to, I'm trying to open the thing up, guys. We're going to have to try and get accommodation which has better views, but can't really see all that much here, which I'm not that happy about. But I went downstairs for breakfast, and down the front there, they've got like a little walkway area where you can stand and have a look outside, which was locked last night because it was dark, I guess, for safety reasons and whatnot. But I'm looking forward to having a look at the views from there, which would be neat because it's right in the water. It's absolutely insane. Like, as soon as we got on the boat, like on the water taxi thing yesterday, I was just like, this is insane. I think it's the first place that I've visited so far where literally from the airport you have to get transported by like water transport to get to land. So that's pretty neat. So yeah, I'm going to take you guys with me today, of course, and hopefully we'll get some amazing photos and videos, and I'm just looking forward to exploring and just taking heaps of photos because that's the best thing ever. Yeah, look at this, guys. Oh my God. So amazing, guys. It's freezing, but oh my God, this place is so magical. You can completely tell that Disney based a lot of their locations on places like this, no doubt. whispering because it's so peaceful and you don't want to ruin that peacefulness. But oh my god. Managed to find a bank. It cost €6 to change the money, which is a fantastic, instead of being charged near £20 to get money converted in the airport yesterday. Also, they don't exchange kronas at the bank, so I need to find a. I've still got like about 60, maybe about 40, 50 pounds worth of kronas left from the Iceland trip. So yeah, I need to find that out. So I've headed over to this sort of the most central area or the main square in Venice. And thankfully, one of the perks of coming at this time of the year is that it's completely dead. So I think it'd be a perfect spot to get the drone out maybe tomorrow morning first thing. So kind of scouting to see where the best location will be for that. But less of the talking. Here is, it's pretty beautiful. I just went into a free music museum a few minutes ago. And that was really awesome. Think about Europe, or I guess most Western countries, is trying to do it on a budget. It doesn't have to be all that expensive because there's a lot of free stuff to do in cities like this, including museums, obviously the walk-in. If you're into photography, there's heaps of photo opportunities. There's just so much you can see and do. So yeah, I'm not too sure I'm gonna go in here. Oh my god, guys, it is so cold. I have to come back to the hotel because I was just freezing my ass off. It is now around about 2, what time is it? Let's check. Yeah, it's 2:15 in the afternoon, and I've been out since about 10:30, 11-ish, something like that. But I am just so cold. So I found a supermarket because I wanted to get some bits. I had some breakfast obviously here at the hotel this morning, which I'm going to keep up over the next few days. But I just can't seem to find many places that do like warm salads and stuff like that. Maybe I'm just not looking in the right places. And I just don't fancy eating pizza and pasta for the next few days. I had this gnocchi last night, which was like a 4-cheese type gnocchi, which was, it was okay, but it was really sort of stodgy and just a bit too much for me. But the dessert was absolutely beautiful. It was a gelato catalana, creme catalana, and it tasted absolutely divine. Kind of want one again. Anyway, so I found this supermarket. It was called Coop, I guess. That's the bag for it. And I managed to get some bits. And I paid €6. Oh my god, it's falling everywhere. €6.61. I don't know if you guys can see that. But I got quite a bit. Now, the only thing is, I find it really strange that they don't have, like, tea and coffee. It's probably just not a local thing here, maybe. But, like, in the hotel room, which I find kind of weird. But I've never visited here before, so I don't really know what the pros and cons are. I got some bread. Little bits of bread. I got a massive bottle of water because I really wanted some last night and I didn't want to go out when it's even cold to get some. I got a tub of Rocket, and then I got 3 of these little drinks. I don't really know what flavour it is. It might be like lime or lemon. No idea. I will find out when I have one. And I also got a Pringles tub. So for €6.61, that's pretty good going. I could probably eat that tonight if I wanted to. I just wanted some green, so I thought I'll just go and get some Rocket or whatever I could find. So I found that by... that was over by Rialto Bridge, so I took a wander down Rialto Bridge. It was quite nice. I think I'm going to head over one morning for sunrise just to try and get pictures and videos of it super quiet, as it was really touristy. The great thing is at the moment it seems to be off-peak, so there's not a lot of people around really, which I'm really, really happy about. And it's nice. I mean, the location where I'm staying, which is in St. Angelo, it's a sort of a 10-minute walk from St. Marco, so it's pretty much bang right in the middle, but then it's only 10 minutes walk from Rialto as well, so maybe 10, 15 minutes, something like that. So it's kind of on the quieter side of town, I think. As I walked into Rialto, you can tell that it's sort of like the mainstream or the more popular touristy area. As you started getting your high street stores, so you've got like your H&Ms and all the high-end type of fashion stuff. So I'm glad that we kind of booked over this way, as it's a bit away from the hustle and bustle, which is nice. I changed my face. Had a quick shower. It's about 4 o'clock, maybe about just after 4 p.m. So I'm gonna head out for a little while and I might get some dessert. I'm not too sure yet. Don't really know what to eat tonight. Like, I bought those bits in the supermarket, but I kind of want something warm just because I've been freezing my ass off all day. Had another shower literally to get warm. The room's nice and warm though, but still, you know, when you're like icy cold and you just, doesn't matter what you do, it just ends up you being freezing. So yeah, I'm gonna head out. Sunset should be around at 5-ish, just before 5, so I thought if I head out now I should be able to get some decent photos maybe as the sun sets, possibly. And then I think I'm just gonna have a bit of a gallivant. Also was looking into what to do tomorrow, and it's a toss-up between heading to Burano or going to the Jewish ghetto. It's meant to be a little bit less touristy, so I'm kind of considering that as well, but I'm still in two minds about heading over to the Dolomite Mountains. It's just that the tour price is so expensive, so I'm a bit like, don't know if I want to do it on this trip or not. But yes, so I'm going to take you guys with me. Let's go. Aloha. So I'm back at the hotel. Went out for a while. The sunset was absolutely divine, guys. Like, it was amazing. I'm so glad that I went out to get that. Skies are really ready pink. There was snow forecasted for this week, but it seems to have shifted quite a bit, so I'm not too sure if we will get snow by the time Sunday arrives. I head back on Sunday back to Manchester, but we shall see. It would be amazing to obviously experience that here in Venice, but we'll have to see. Food-wise, I ended up getting this falafel wrap. It was €3.50, and obviously I got some water and bits earlier on in the day, so that's going to tie me over for tonight. I really wanted some yummy dessert, but I think I might have to go and find a place tomorrow. And it's about 5:30, so it's still pretty early, but I think I am done for the day. And I'm going to get an early night tonight, so I actually wake up super early tomorrow and get sunrise from somewhere. I'm thinking of taking the drone out tomorrow as well. Hopefully I don't crash it, but we will have to see how that one goes. But yeah, see you guys tomorrow.